Hi guys, today we are starting with anatomy, simple anatomy. This is my first video. We'll be discussing brief topics which are frequently asked in many competitive exams. Okay, this is for beginners. So let's start. A common question, how many number in vertebrae? This 33, vertebrae are 33 in number. What is the formula? Cervical, it will be how much?
7.
C7. Thoracic, it will be?
12.
Lumbar, how much?
5.
Sacral?
5.
Coccyx?
It will be 4.
So it will be 33. Then how many spinal nerves we have? Spinal nerves is 31 pairs, right? So the formula will be C8, T12, L5, S5, C1, Coccyx will be 1. So 20, 30, 31. Okay, that is 31 pairs of spinal nerves, and vertebra we have 33. Okay, let's continue. Now we are moving to upper limb. So we have 33 in number, vertebra 33 in number, spinal nerves 31 pairs. Memorize that one. Now we are moving to upper limb. Upper limb. See, in anatomy, we'll take the reference. See, for upper limb, it is always lateral to medial. So, see here, lateral, we have radius, right? In medial, we have ulna bone, that is in palmar side. Okay, so in anatomy, always for upper limb, take lateral to medial. So, in radial, in lateral side, we have ulna bone every time. And in medial side, we have what? Ulna bone, in lateral radial and medial ulna bone. So if you are turning our, we are taking, looking for dorsal side, don't turn your hand, see, it will be same for dorsal side, we will look like this. So in medial side, what is ulna bone, and in radial side, sorry, in lateral side, we have radial bone. This is in palmar side as well as dorsal side. So in upper limb, the reference is like lateral to medial. Okay, clear? See, now it will be humerus, it is radius bone, it will be ulna bone, okay, that is lateral side and this is medial side. These are the carpal bones. How many carpal bones do we have? We have 8, carpal bones are 8 in number, okay, and we have this humerus, radius, ulna, and we have 8 carpals, 5 metacarpals, right, and 14 phalanges. Okay, we have humerus, radius ulna, 8 carpals, 5 metacarpals and 14 phalanges. Memorize this. And there is specific name for these carpal bones. Okay. So how to memorize? So this is the proximal, right? Proximal part. Proximal. And this is the distal. So here the mnemonics here is, remember, she looks true pretty. Remember, she looks true pretty. So she S for scaphoidium or scaphoid. L for lunatum or lunate. And T for tricuspid. Okay, she looks true pretty. And P for pisiform or O pisiforme. These are the proximal carpal bones. Then goes to distal, that is TTCH. Here it is try to catch her. So mnemonics is she looks true pretty and tries to catch her. So here it will be trapezoid. And here is here we have capitate. Here we have hematite or hematum or hematite. Clear? Sorry, I made a mistake here. This is trapezium and this is trapezoid. So how to memorize this? See the mnemonics, she looks true pretty, tries to catch her. So you can remember scaphoid, lunatum, trichotillon, pisiform and trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, hematite. That is from lateral to medial. See the position, lateral to medial. In the radial bone side, we have scaphoid bone. Okay, clear. Then the most common asked in many exams. Among carpal bones, which is the bone mostly fractured or breaks? If you have any accident or if you fall, which bone is fractured more or common fracturing bone? That is scaphoid. So scaphoid, they breaks or common fracture. Okay, remember, I remember like this. She is she. Okay, so always breakup comes from she. Okay, her. Okay, remember she. So scaphoid, she loves to break up. Okay, so breakups come from she, that is scaphoid. Okay, then the other question, which bone among carpal bones used to dislocate? That is lunate. So here you can see 8. So dislocate, most common dislocating bone is lunate. Clear? So which bone among carpal bone they are undergoing fracture is common bone among carpal bone which is undergoing fracture is scaphoid. Okay, at the same time there was other question, which bone in our body among total bones in our body is commonly fractured? That is clavicle. Okay, clavicle is the bone, clavicle most common fracture. Clavicle is the bone. Here we will discuss detail later, because this scaphoid is the bone among carpal bone which is likely to be fractured more, but clavicle is the most common bone in our body to be fractured. Okay, clear? Okay, then which is the smallest bone? Which is the smallest bone? That is pisiform. See pisiform. So remember pisiform, it is in ulnar side. Okay, the small finger, little finger. So smallest bone is pisiform. Remember smallest. Clear? And next one is, which is the largest bone among carpal bone? That is capitate. How can we remember this? Capitate, you know, capital city.
One doubt, like you told, like mnemonics, like she look true pretty try to catch her.
Yeah,
like H for hematite or hemate bone.
It can be hematite or hematum or hematite, just remember, that's all. Okay, see capitate, it is the largest bone. It can be, you can call it as hematum or hemate, anything. It depends on language. There will be, you can write hematum, you can see different names, but common hemate or hematite or hemate or hematum, you can remember. So the question is, which is the largest bone among carpal bones? That is capitate. How can you remember? So you know London is the capital of England. Okay, London is the big city, right? So remember capital, that is the largest, it will be largest. So capitate is the largest bone among carpal bones. Okay, we know Delhi is the big city. So Delhi is the capital of India. So remember, capital, it will be largest. So scaphoid, she looks, so first of all, mnemonic, she looks true pretty, try to catch her. Here, she is for scaphoid. This is the common bone, which is likely to be fractured among carpal bones. Like, remember, she or the lady loves to break up, right? So remember, which is the more common bone to be fractured, that is scaphoid. So lunate, dislocate, remember like that. Pisiform, it is the smallest bone, and capital, it's a larger city, the capital will be largest bone. Clear? These are the carpal bones, and this is known as carpal metacarpal joint. Okay, CMC, carpal CMC, carpal metacarpal joint. Clear? Now, what is the clinical importance of these carpal bones? Okay. See, call a girl, a 5-year-old child girl, okay, and ask her to close her eyes, okay, but you don't know the age of the girl, and start counting her carpal bones. If you see 5 carpal bones or 4 carpal bones, it will be 4, the age will be 4, then tell her you are 5 years old, she will be surprised. It is not magic, this is science, okay, it is part of anatomy. So, according to the age, if 5-year-old child have 5 carpal bone, okay? 5-year-old child have 5 carpal bone. So, in 12 year have 8 carpal bones. So, carpal bones completely develop in 12 year, okay? So, you can identify age in some cases, okay? So, till puberty, in puberty, it will be completely developed. So, carpal bone is completely developed in puberty. So, if 6 carpal bone, she is 6-year-old, okay? Clear? Clear about carpals, everything, right? So, let's move to next topic, that is, remember, this clinical value, importance, it is only up to 12 years. So in 12 years, we will have all carpal bones. Tomorrow, don't ask your girlfriend to close your eyes and tell her you only have 7 bones, you are only 7 years old. So she may slap you. It is only applicable till 12 years. 12 years, we will have all carpal bones. Okay, we will get breakup, that is scaphoidium. Scaphoidium. It is a common bone which is to be fractured, right? Next is sesamoid bones. What is sesamoid bones? You know, in our body, all bones develop from cartilage or membrane, okay? But these sesamoid bones, they develop from tendon. Clear? They develop from tendon. We have different sesamoid bones. First one is patella, second is fibula, third one is pisiform, and we have a rider's bone. These bone develops from tendon. You know what is the difference between tendon and cartilage? Tendon connects muscle to bone. How to remember? Tendon, TMB, that is tendon connects muscle to bone. What is ligament? Ligament connect bone to bone, LBB. Just remember one, TMB means tendon connects muscle to bone, or bone to muscle, connection between muscle and bone. But LBB, that is ligament bone to bone. Just remember one, other you can, so don't confuse. So these muscles, sorry, these bones develop from tendons, okay? So memorize patella, you know the patellar bone, the knee joint, the patellar bone. So they develop from tendons of quadriceps femoris, okay? Quadriceps femoris. And this fibula bone, you know the gastrocnemius muscle here, right? So they develop from lateral head of gastrocnemius. Okay, fibula develop from gastrocnemius lateral head. Clear? Pisiform. What we talked about pisiform? This is smallest among carpal bones. So I told you it is in the ulnar side, the little finger side, right? Okay. So it will. It is from flexor carpi ulnaris. And the last one, the rider's bone. You know the horse riding, right? The bone present in the thigh. It is developed from adductor longus of thigh muscle. So once more, what is sesamoid bones? The bones which develops from tendon. Okay, normally bone develop from membranes or cartilages, but here the patella, fibula, important sesamoid bones, patella, fibula, pisiform, radius bone. Just memorize from where they develop. Patella from tendons of quadriceps femoris, fibula gastrocnemius, pisiform flexor carpi ulnaris, from radius bone from adductor longus of thigh bone. Okay, this is the first part. We'll continue with anatomy. So thank you for watching. Share and subscribe. Thank you.